Welcome to the virtual practical on impact of jet, that is verification of impulse momentum principle of the subject turbo machines of PE Mechanical 2015 course part 1. We acknowledge our sincere thanks to the following authors and courtesy for being used these concepts to make this video session. In this session, you will be able to explain practical relevance, importance, and the procedure of verifying impulse momentum principle, and you will also be able to analyze the reasons for deviation in theoretical and actual value of force applied by the jet on a plate. This session contains theory and performance analysis of impact of jet on a plate and explanation of performance of experiment, which includes objectives, observations, how to produce result tables, performance of calculations, and conclusions. Verification of impulse momentum principle is the aim of this practical. So, objectives are study impulse force, study impulse momentum principle, and verify impulse momentum principle using flat, inclined, and curved plate. Let us discuss about impulsive force. A force acting over a short interval of time on a body is called impulsive force. For example, here is a shown kick given to a ball. So it is an impulse that is equal to force into time interval. Its unit is Newton second. So this concept is used in case of linear motion as to express force, which is used to move this body from its initial position to final position. Also, in case of rotary motion, here this is the impact of jet on the curved plate in case of built on wheel. Use of plates or vanes in turbo machines. Here we find this example of a belt on wheel. Here we observe that this bucket is subjected with impact of jet, that is impulse turbine. This is cut section view and this is one blade view of belt on bucket. In case of reaction, that is Francis turbine, here we see this is a runner which consists number of blades. So here is a cut section view of Francis runner. This is actual photograph of Francis runner. The blades of the runner are curved in nature. So this is single blade. Impulse momentum principle, which is used to find the force. So it states that the impulse exerted on any body is equal to the resulting change in momentum of the body. From Newton's second law, we can write F is equal to mass into acceleration. Further, it is m into dv by dt or t into mu by dt. So from this we can write in this way. So this is what impulse, that is change in momentum, and force is what mass into velocity means momentum divided by change in time means rate of change of momentum. So by this definition we can write formula for F force, that is initial momentum minus final momentum divided by time. Initial momentum is what? Mass into initial velocity minus final momentum is mass into final velocity divided by time. Further, mass upon time we take outside of the bracket. Mass of time is mass flow rate. Now this concept we use for the fleet. Here application of jet with velocity v1 as initial and v2 as a final. So formula for force is equal to m dot into v1 minus v2 in Newton, where m dot is mass flow rate in kg per second and v1 v2 are the velocities of jet in meter per second. Now for the different plates, for fixed plate the formula force exerted by jet in the direction of jet is rho a v square in Newton. In case of jet striking on fixed inclined plate, it is rho a v square sine square theta in Newton, where theta is angle between the jet and plate. For the case of jet striking to curved fixed plate, the formula is rho a v square into 1 plus cos theta in Newton, where theta is the angle made by the jet at outdeck with respect to horizontal direction of jet. Now we will see about the impact of jet test rig. So this is a test rig in a lab. Components of the test rig are: this is a sump tank which is used to store the water. Monoblock pump is used to lift the water. Flow control valve is used to control and regulate the flow, which is directed towards the blade or plate. This is vane chamber in which the plate is fixed or attached. This is a jet nozzle which imparts jet on the plate. This is a discharge measuring tank, discharge valve, discharge measuring scale. This is lever mechanism, dead weight or balance weight, and weight hanger. Now we will see each one. Sump tank, monoblock pump, flow control valve. This is vane chamber, nozzle. This is flat plate and this is curved plate. Inclined plate is already attached to the vane chamber. This is discharge measuring tank. Here is a discharge valve. And this is discharge scale. This is lever mechanism. This is balance mark, dead weight or balance weight. This is hanger weight, and this is hanger, and these are the weights. This is block diagram of experimental test rig, which is used for the write-up purpose. These are the observations. Area of discharge tank is given in millimeter, that we have to convert into meter and then calculate as an area in meter square. Diameter of jet D is given in mm. Area of jet calculate by using formula pi by 4 into D square. Take diameter in meter, so get area in meter square, this value. Angle of inclined plate is given as a theta 60 degree, and angle of curved plate is given theta as 55 degree. Density of water is to be taken 1000 kg per meter cube. Distance of jet force from the hinge as a y, and distance of weight from hinge as a x. These two distances are given in mm. Take these distances in meter. Now we conduct this experiment or practical for three types of plates: inclined plate, flat plate and curved plate. Let's have observation table. This is a sample. So here we have to use weights in a gram. First trial we take 50 gram, then we take 60, 70, 80, 90. So this we use for the each kind of plate. This is the height difference. For this height difference we take the time for HMM rise, and that we write in this respective column. Now we will first of all perform the test on impact object on inclined plate. So for that procedure is what? First of all, balance the lever mechanism by adjustment of balance weight to coincide marking on the lever and acrylic support plate. Then start the motor, allow the discharge of water as a jet, then apply first weight in a gram to the hanger. So lever gets unbalanced, then bring that in balance condition by adjusting flow control valve so that water discharge will pass the plate. Then close the discharge valve of measuring tank and then measure the time needed for HMM rise by using watch. Repeat this experiment for the different weights. Then this experimental procedure is same for flat plate and curved plate also. Now we will see here actual performance of the test. So here we can see this actual setup in a lab. Here we can find this is a flow control valve, this is a discharge valve, these are the specifications given over here. Then this is a nozzle in the vane chamber and fitted inclined plate. This is a lever mechanism. This is a balance weight. By using this balance weight, we do the balancing. So first of all, here without weight, first of all, we do the balancing of this lever arm by adjustment of that balance weight, which is here on the right hand side. We do this process until these two markings will be matched, marking on this lever mechanism and marking on the acrylic support. Then we start the motor, pump is started, now discharge is going on. Now this discharge we have to divert to this plate through this nozzle. So for that purpose we use this valve, flow control valve. So by rotating this flow control valve, what we do, we divert the flow of water to the plate through the nozzle. Now what happens, we see here by the application of water, this arm will be lifted up. Now when it will come in equilibrium position, then we take first weight as a 50 gram and then we apply this weight here on the location on the hanger here. Then it comes in unbalanced position, so again we have to increase the discharge which is striking to the plate, thus this plate will be rising up. Then we have to regulate this discharge until this horizontal bar, that is lever mechanism, will come in equilibrium position. When it will come in equilibrium position, then we close this discharge valve and we allow the water to rise in the discharge tank. Then here we take here initial position, that HI. Then we start the watch, digital watch, and we take reading of timing for 5 cm rise between initial HI reading and HF reading for 50 mm. So we get here this time in actual practical when we took this was 18.62 seconds. So this is a time for first wait, then we release the water and then we go for second reading of the weight. Now we add weight of 10 gram to the 50 gram of hanger. So total weight is now 60 gram. So second reading is for 60 gram. Now again this has become unbalanced condition. So to make this in balanced mode, again we increase the discharge by using flow control valve. So discharge is allowed till this will come in balanced condition, means the marking on the lever mechanism and acrylic plate support will be matched. Okay, so when these two will be matched, in that case we will take second reading for this 60 gram weight. So for that we follow the same procedure, means closing of valve and taking the time. So we will now here enter sample observation in this table for the inclined plate for first weight 50 gram and for 50 mm rise H, and that time we got that was 18.62 seconds. Sample calculations for inclined plate. First discharge, formula is area of tank into height divided by time. So area of tank we already have in observation. Height is 50 mm means 0.05 meter divided by time reading 18.62. We get discharge in meter cube per second. Then we find velocity of jet by using formula Q by A, where area is area of jet. This is also is mentioned in observations. So we find velocity. Then theoretical force applied by the jet. This is inclined plate. So formula is rho a v square sine square theta. Here value of rho, area of jet, velocity and theta. For inclined plate, theta value is mentioned 60 degree. So we get theoretical force in Newton. Then actual force of the jet, for that calculation we need to take moment due to forces about hinge. So here we need diagram. In this diagram we see this is application of weight on the lever, this is application of jet on the plate, here is a hinge location. So distance of weight from the hinge is x and distance of this is y. So here we write the equation for the moment. So w into x is w into x, this is anti-clockwise momentum moment, that's why negative sign, and f actual into y, this is a clockwise momentum moment, that's why sign is plus. So by arranging this equation we get here formula f actual is equal to w into x by y. So here putting the value of w means weight in a gram, conversion into kilogram means by multiply with 10 raised to minus 3, then conversion into newton because it's a force calculation, so multiplied by 9.81. so putting the value of x, that is 0.485, and value of y, that is 0.185. so we find actual force in newton, then calculate coefficient of impact means k is a ratio of actual to theoretical force. So we get value of k, then we enter all these calculated values in result table of inclined plate. Ahead the weight of 50 gram, So discharge, velocity, theoretical force, actual force, and coefficient of impact. So for the other weights, we can follow the same procedure. Then you have to plot the graph between discharge and forces. So let us see. For that, we take on the vertical axis theoretical force and actual force, and on horizontal axis we take discharge. We plot by using the values for theoretical force. This is shown by blue color line, and this is a plot of actual force. So from this we find the conclusions. Observations, if you do, we find that as the discharge increases, as the discharge of jet increases, values of F actual and theoretical increases. Second is what? F actual is less than F theoretical. This is because of loss of energy in splashing of water. So ratio of F actual to F theoretical comes less than 1. So this was the graph and conclusion for the inclined plate. Now we replace the plate with flat plate. So this is a flat plate which is shown here. For the flat plate observation table here, for flat plate, first reading for 50 gram, as usual we repeat the same procedure of inclined plate. So for 50 mm rise, we get the time in second that we write here. Then we do the sample calculation of flat plate. The procedure is same as of inclined plate. So discharge calculation here, time for the flat plate we write, area of tank and height are same as of inclined. We calculate discharge, we calculate velocity. Then for the theoretical force, we use the formula of flat plate, that is rho a v square. Here by putting the values, we get theoretical force. Then calculation of actual force of jet is same for all plates. The coefficient of impact. Then we add the sample result values in the sample result table. Ahead the first weight, then we follow the same procedure for the practical of all the remaining weights, and we can get all these calculations for the flat plate. Then we plot the graph. This is also again similar as of inclined plate. So conclusion for the flat plates are also same as of inclined plate. Now we replace this with third plate, that is a curved plate. By attaching this curved plate in vane chamber, we follow the same procedure of practical, and first reading for 50 gram of weight and rise of water for 50 mm, we measure the time in measuring tank by using digital watch. So this time is in second for curved plate. So sample calculations for curved plate, again the procedure is same. Discharge, here we put the value of first reading of time for curved plate. Then we calculate the velocity. Then theoretical force applied by the jet, here the formula for curved plate is to be taken rho a v square 1 plus cos theta, and theta value is for the curved plate 55. So here putting the values over here, we get theoretical force. Actual force is the same as of previous. Coefficient of impact we get by the calculation. Then calculated values you can enter in the result table of curved plate. So these are the calculated values for first weight 50 gram. Then plot the graph of Q versus F theoretical and actual. This graph is again same as a previous for curd plate. So obviously conclusions for this will be again same. So now readings for the all plates will be given to you. So here readings are given batch wise. So in a class there are three batches, so batch 1, batch 2 and batch 3. So this is observation table readings for batch 1. Now you can take screenshot of this table for the calculation. So these are the batch 1 readings for all the plates, flat plate, inclined plate and curved plate. So these are all values of time. Okay, these are the weights applied for the each plate. Then for batch 2, these are the readings. You have to take screenshot of this table. Batch 2 students will use these readings. Then batch 3 students will use these readings. Okay, so now role of student, do all the calculations for each plate, means flat plate, inclined plate and curved plate, for the respective load and reading of time, okay, of your batch. Then write the experiment on A4 size ruled pages as explained here. Draw the block diagram of experimental test tree on blank page, which is also explained here. Then prepare observation table, result table and plot graphs for each type of plate separately. Then write the conclusion for each plate as explained here. So at the end of this session, you can explain practical relevance, significance, importance and the procedure of verifying impulse momentum principle, and you can analyze the reasons for deviation in theoretical and actual value of force applied by the jet. So if you like this video, please subscribe and share. Thank you.